Okay, the video I'm doing today is how to repair a KitchenAid Professional 600 mixer. This particular one we've purchased December of 2008, and we used it once or twice a year, and it's January of 2012, and already it's broken. And we called KitchenAid, and they said there was nothing they can do other than to send it in for repair. So I thought I'd repair it myself. So here are some of the things you'll need to do the same repair. You'll need some tools. You'll need a Phillips screwdriver, a putty knife to get a lot of the grease out of the transmission case, a punch, a set of needle nose pliers, a snap ring plier that I purchased over at Home Depot, and a screwdriver. Now, what this particular one does is it turns on, it runs, but it doesn't spin. And with this particular model, a lot of problems are with the gears. And one or two types of gears go bad, and that's what happened in this particular case. Now, one of the sites that will help is mendingshed.com. On that, they sell genuine KitchenAid replacement parts, gears and such. And then also, you can they have the service manual, and you can go and print that on out, and that'll help quite a bit in terms of the repair. So what I did on this one is to determine what parts I've needed, I've taken it apart, cleaned it out, determined the gears, and I actually went and ordered the parts, and I have them here today. What I'll do is I'll show you how to, you know, take it apart. Some of which, the gearbox has been cleaned out. There'll be a lot of grease in your particular one when you first open it. But here we go. Okay, so on this particular model, there's a screw at the back that has to come out. Once you pull that on out, you're able to take this piece on off, and you just set it aside. And then on the side here, there is two screws on each side. You need to remove those on each side. And once you've done that, you're able to carefully remove off the top, set that aside, and that exposes the transmission cover, which is the next part to go to remove off if you suspect you have a gear issue. Okay, now I've positioned the camera above the mixer here just to give you a better shot at the gearbox. And the first thing you have to do, there's going to be four screws that you have to pull out. In this particular case, I've already removed those. So one here, one here, one there. And then if you can see one right down there. Okay. And you pull those screws on out, and that'll allow you to lift the gearbox off carefully. Okay. Now that the gearbox is off, it'll expose the gears here. And in this particular one, this is all cleaned up. If you're opening up for the first time, you'll have quite a bit of grease inside the transmission cover here. And you'll have a lot of grease within the gears. Now, one of the things I want to make sure you know is be careful with this gasket so you don't break it. That way you won't have leaks, grease leaks later on after your repair. And you can set that to the side. And what I recommend doing is taking everything apart and inspect all of your gears for wear. Because while you have it apart, you might as well replace everything that looks like there's wear. These are, fairly inexpensive when I purchased them, some of which are, kind of a few bucks a piece here. Now, one of the things I do want to note is when you do order your replacements, not only you have to order replacements, but you also have to order grease, and it comes in a can such as this. Unfortunately, it's one size, and this was actually the most expensive of all the replacements I had to purchase for my particular unit. So first thing you do is get it all cleaned off, and I recommend using some type of putty knife to go in there, get the grease off, and use quite a bit of paper towels while you're working on it. You have some handy for your hands as you work on your unit here. Okay, so starting off here, in this particular unit, what most goes is this particular gear right here, and this is the worm gear. The worm gear assembly, the gear itself here goes, and there's these bushings and bearings that'll come on off there. And my particular unit, this was good. In my particular unit, I didn't have a problem with this particular one, so I'm going to just set that aside here. The next thing you do here is there's a little snap ring on the top of this shaft. You'll go ahead, use your pliers here, and your retention clip pliers, go ahead and pull that on off. And this is the part that was bad in my particular unit here, and this is called the bevel gear. And you can see there's a number of missing teeth there, and don't exactly know how that happened. We use this very lightly, but that is in case what happened. Next, what you'll do is you can use a little punch, and there's a little pin here, and you punch that on out. And it was very easy to get mine out there, and that pulls on out. And then there's this worm follower gear that you can then pull up and off like that, and have your hand underneath the bottom piece, because this whole unit will come on out, exposing that. And that's what I got here. And in this particular one, I actually ordered another one of these because I've noticed some wear on the side here, and the bevel gear sits on top of that. So I believe I'm going to just go ahead and replace that as well. Again, this part, was only like, $3.50 when I purchased it in January of 2012. Now, the one other gear you want to take a look at is inside the transmission cover that slides on out here, and this is for your attachments. This is your hub bevel gear, and go ahead, and that just slides on out, and you can go ahead and clean that off and inspect that. In my particular case, this one's just fine. Now, as I start reassembling the transmission and putting the gears back in, I will start covering the parts with some grease, and what I'll use is I can use a spoon, or I just had laying around some popsicle sticks, so I'm just going to go ahead and use that as I go ahead and reassemble. And basically I'll do that in the reverse order in which everything came out. And again, the service manual is a good aid just to kind of look at and make sure as you take things apart, it has all the pieces. So if you kind of get some things mixed up, where the gears or the bearings or the washers, it'll help assist you putting that back in order. Okay. I'm going to put back on the worm follower gear, and I just covered the bottom that with a little bit of grease that I purchased. And I'm going to push this on up, get that all the way up. I'm going to take that and I'm just going to slide that right on down the shaft there. Okay, and at this point, I will need to insert. There's a pin that you need to insert, and that kind of keeps all this held in place. You can use your needle nose pliers, or just slide that in just like so. Okay, the next thing I need to put on is my bevel gear. Now, one of the things that you need to make sure you got aligned here is your pin. It has to be sticking out equal amounts, and it has to be parallel here, with your worm follower gear. You'll see that it's squared off here, and so you want that parallel. And the reason why I say this is you see that what happens is this fits over the worm follower gear, and then the pin rides within this bevel gear. So you need to make sure that that's aligned when you put it on, otherwise it won't fit on quite correctly. Okay, and now with that aligned, I just put a little bit of grease on that before I assemble it on down, and just kind of work to snap it in place. Okay. So you'll know that when it fits down all the way flush on top of the worm follower gear, you have it on right. The other thing to do, and you can't see that so much here in this video here, but on the shaft here, there's going to be a little cutout here that your retaining ring sits into. That should be just above the bevel gear. Okay. And so the next thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put on my retaining ring, and then I'll start assembling the remaining gears. Okay, I got my retaining ring on now. One of the things you want to make sure of is that the retaining ring fits inside the groove on your shaft here. So make sure that gets in there nice and good, and then you're ready to proceed to the next step. Okay, next thing I'm going to do is put in the worm gear, and we'll just take that and we'll put that right on in here. Make sure that the flat parts are vertical on the ends of the worm gear. Also make sure you've put on your washers and your bearings the proper way, as it had indicated inside the as it indicated in the service manual. Okay, I have this in there, and just exactly how that's supposed to go. All right, now ready to proceed to the next step. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the hub bevel gear that sits inside the transmission cover, and I'm just going to go ahead and slip that on in just like so. Okay, and that's it for the gears. So the gears are all put in, and the next thing to do now is to put 2 ounces of grease inside, repack this with 2 ounces of grease. And so what I'll do is I'll measure 2 ounces and come on back. Okay, well, I've put my 2 ounces of grease on the gears, and also in the transmission cover. And just clean up a little bit of the, if you got any grease on the gasket, just get everything cleaned up so it looks good. And go ahead then, and it's time then to take this and put the transmission cover back on and start getting everything screwed down again. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just get my screws set on in. But there is a particular order to get these tightened in, and I'll show you that once I just get these just a little bit snug, I'll show you the order. Okay, I've repositioned the camera a little bit, so hopefully you can see a little better at the top here. So the order to get these things tightened down is, by the way, this is the front and this is the rear. So the motor's to the right of where I'm actually standing here, okay? And so it's 1, 2, 3, 4. And so we'll get them all tightened up and snugged down in that order. Make sure they're snug, don't over tighten them. Okay, and that's it. It's all put together, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go around and just make sure I've cleaned up any grease that's got on the outside here of the cover, and we'll go ahead and put the top on then. Okay, now that I've got everything cleaned up, time to we'll put the go ahead and put the cover back on. Basically, it's the same thing, reverse order that you did. There'll be two screws on each side. Go ahead and put those in. I'm going to go ahead and get the silver cover back on, and then we'll try it on out. Okay, I have it all back together again, and what I'll do is go ahead and plug it in and see how it works. Okay, there you go. That's how you go ahead and prepare a KitchenAid Professional 600 mixer.